Hello, my name's Craig Earl, a market analyst at Alpari UK, and welcome to our daily market update. Today we're going to take a look at some of the main events really moving the markets over the past 24 hours and also take a look ahead at what we can expect today. Now, the main real thing that people have been talking about in the markets is Ben Bernanke's testimony on the semi-annual monetary policy report, firstly yesterday in front of the House Financial Services Committee and then later on again today in front of the Senate Banking Committee. Now, yesterday we didn't really get too much out of this testimony, and I think there's a couple of reasons for this. I think the Ben Bernanke and the Fed have actually been one of the more transparent central banks in the world. They've actually given a lot away over the past few, especially over the past few months, about what they plan to do with tapering later this year, as long as the economy performs in line with projections, in the sense that they've already put a date, essentially a target on when they're going to consider increasing the interest rates when unemployment falls to 6.5%. So I think they've been pretty open about it. So there was only ever going to be certain things we could potentially learn from this, potentially exactly when they're going to begin tapering, how much they're going to begin tapering by. But I think at this stage, maybe the Fed themselves don't necessarily know these details, which is why we didn't really learn too much. One of the things which did shake the market a little was Ben Bernanke suggesting that there's no necessarily set date when the Fed are going to begin tapering, that it's very data dependent, that it could come earlier than the end of the year, it could come at the end of the year, or it could still come later than the end of the year if the economy doesn't perform in line projections. But again, this is just essentially restating something he's already said previously, although Bernanke's comments do tend to, like say, cause a bit of a stir in the market. So we did see a bit of movement, but compared to what we've seen in the past from Bernanke, it was actually really quite small. So not necessarily too much learned from this. So again, expectations are essentially pretty low for tonight's testimony. I don't really think we'll learn too much here. I think, like I say, with the fact that they've been so transparent already, there's not really too much that the Fed and Ben Bernanke can actually give away here. So while all eyes are going to be on this testimony, I think expectations are relatively low. Looking at the market so far today, and in the UK we've had the release of the retail sales figure for June. Now, this came out well in line with expectations month on month at 0.2%. The year on year figure came out at 2.2%, which was above expectations, and the previous month's year on year figure was actually revised higher, so all positive here. But I think the real positive point here was the retail sales figure excluding fuel costs. Now, as we all know from being at the pump, that fuel costs have been extremely volatile over the past few years. So when you strip out these fuel costs, the actual year-on-year figure was plus 2.1%, well ahead of expectations, and again last month's figure was revised higher. So it's extremely positive here. It would suggest, as with the other data, that the economy really is improving. I mean, when you take out the fuel costs, it is just focusing more on what people are spending in department stores, how much people are spending, how much the consumer's spending on their day-to-day life. And I think this is a better bearing for the entire economy. And I think what this does suggest, especially given the fact that this is the second consecutive month-on-month increase in retail sales, the first time we've seen that since the same time last year, it would suggest that the UK economy is looking like it's on a sustainable footing, like we are seeing a sustainable improvement in the UK economy. Obviously, this can turn negative again later this year. But these early pieces of data do suggest that what we are seeing here is a bit more of a sustainable recovery. And that again just brings us back to what we can expect from the Bank of England and all this. The economy is improving. So it does beg the question of, does the Bank of England need to intervene? And is the reason why we saw these more hawkish comments from the Bank of England from the minutes yesterday, is this why we saw them? Because the economy is improving, and therefore there's no reason. The risks associated with increasing the asset purchase facility aren't necessarily offset by the improvements which can be expected in the economy. Now, I think the forward guidance here is still important. I think for business confidence and for consumer confidence, especially with households wanting to, with their mortgages, if they're going to keep up with their mortgage repayments, whether they're looking to take out loans in order for anything, whether it's buying cars or anything like this, or especially for businesses though who are looking to invest in the actual business. I think these this forward guidance, whether it's going to be something like the US with linked to unemployment, something like Mark Carney brought to Canada with a certain date in the future, be it maybe mid-2015, or maybe something new, maybe he's going to link it to growth. I do think this forward guidance is going to be very important for the Bank of England, and also could actually give the UK economy that little bit of an extra boost. And I think we can expect to see that, not necessarily at the next meeting on August the 1st, but maybe on August the 7th, when we'll hear from Mark Carney again. Looking ahead to the rest of today, and again, the focus is going to remain with the US. We've got the initial jobless claims out at 130. Now, these are expected to fall to 345,000 last week. After that little slip last week when it rose to 360,000, if we do see another higher figure again, it would suggest that maybe we are seeing a bit of a deterioration in the US labour market, like Bernanke was suggesting yesterday. But I think we are going to see it fall back to that 345,000 figure, or that's at least what the markets are expecting at the moment. We've also got the Philly Fed Manufacturing Index that's expected at 7.8, down from 12.5 a month ago. But again, I think a lot of attention again, now that we're seeing less focus maybe on tapering and the central banks, a lot of focus now is going to switch to the corporate earnings season. And today we're going to hear from Morgan Stanley reporting second quarter earnings, as well as Verizon Wireless, who, and again, I think it's going to be the details in Verizon's earnings report which is going to be important, in particular how many Apple iPhones were activated in the last quarter, given the fact that Apple are the largest company in the S&P 500. And then later on after the US close as well, we're going to hear from Google and also Microsoft. So some major companies reporting today, and I think the corporate earnings season really is going to be a key driver for the markets in the coming weeks and months. For more news and analysis, check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom. And you can also follow us on Twitter. Thank you very much for listening. My name's Craig Earl, a market analyst at Alpari UK.